Good morning everyone. Okay, today we are going to discuss about 7th class lesson, that is reproduction in plants. Okay, this is our first session in this lesson. Okay, first of all you should know about what is reproduction. What is reproduction? Reproduction is producing children, from parents. That nothing but these children in biology, these are also called as offsprings. Okay, now we can say that reproduction is the production of children from the parents is called as reproduction. Reproduction, production of children as like the parents, having slightly differences or as it is copies of the parent is called as reproduction, because some organisms having as it is copies of their children, but some organism having differences and variations in their children when compared to the parents. Like us human beings, our parents and us, we are different to each other. We have some variations when compared to our parents and us, okay? But in case of some plants, there is no differences between parent and the children. That is about reproduction. Then, first of all, in 7th class, you have to know what are the structures present in the flower. Before going to that, I want to discuss about one thing. Here, the plants, those can form flowers. That means flowering plants are simply called as phanerogams. Okay, phanerogams. And non-flowering plants are called as cryptogams. Flowering plants are called as phanerogams. Non-flowering plants are called as cryptogams. In flowering plants only sexual reproduction will take place. That means if the plant having the flower, it can involve in sexual reproduction. If the plant doesn't have any flower, it does not involve in sexual reproduction. Okay, phanerogams includes bryophyta, pteridophyta, and thallophyta. These are the groups involved in the phanerogams. Those are flower. Sorry. Okay, thallophyta, bryophyta, pteridophyta are the non-flowering plants. These are the group of non-flowering plants. Okay, phanerogams includes angiosperms and gymnosperms. Angiosperms and gymnosperms. Okay, these are the flowering plants. This is introduction about the plants having flowering, and plants do not possess any flowers. Okay, then we are going to discuss about flower and its parts. In flowering plants, the flower having the flower having four ovules, four ovules. Those are calyx, corolla, andrecium and gynecium. These are the four ovules of the plant. These are the four ovules of the plant. Okay, what is that? Calyx, corolla, number 3 andrecium, and number 4 gynecium. Gynecium. Okay, now let us observe here. This is a Datura flower, longitudinal section. It is cutted in longitudinally, that's why it is called as longitudinal section. Okay, in this session the green color, this is a green colored area or whorl is called as calyx. If you observe a Datura flower or hibiscus flower, you should observe that a green colored portion present above the stalk, to which the flower is present. Okay, flower, this is flower, this is hibiscus flower, this is stamen. Now here calyx is the green colored portion present just above the stalk. This is called as stalk of the flower. With this stalk only the flower attached to the stem. Okay, with this stalk portion only the flower attached to the stem. Above the stalk the green colored portion is present, it is called as calyx. Second, above the calyx in Datura flower a white colored portion present, it is called as corolla. In hibiscus also red colored portion is nothing but corolla. Okay, hibiscus, here green colored portion is called as calyx. Okay, this is stalk. This is about two whorls are completed. This is calyx and corolla. Now, what is andrecium? Andrecium is the male reproductive part in flower. This indicates that male portion. That means, if you observe the LS of the Datura, you can observe that there is some structures I drawn here. Okay, these structures are called as andrecium. These structures are called as andrecium. So these are simply called as, the stalk is called as stamen. The stalk of andrecium is called as stamen. Above the stamen, a sac-like structure is present. This is called as anther. Another name for anther is pollen sac. Okay, overall structure is called as andrecium. That means combination of anther and the stamen is called as andrecium. Why anther is called as pollen sac? Because inside the pollen sac, pollen grains, some powder like grains like structures present inside the pollen sac. Those dotted grain-like structures are called as pollen grains. Pollen grains. These are the main male reproductive structures involved in reproduction at the time of reproduction. Then gynoecium. Then gynoecium. Gynoecium is the female reproductive part of the flower. Female reproductive part of the flower. That means this is this swollen portion inside the dhatura is called as ovary. Ovary. Okay. Above the ovary, this stalk-like structure is called as style. This stalk-like structure is called as style. Above the style, a bead-like structure is present. This structure is named as stigma. This structure is named as stigma. So, the gynoecium involves three parts: ovary, style, and stigma. Ovary, style and stigma collectively called as gynoecium. Gynoecium is the female reproductive part. Okay, inside the ovary there are small egg shaped structures are present. These structures are called as ovules. Okay. So I mentioned here pollen grains and here as ovules. The fusion of pollen grains with the ovules is called as fertilization. So through these structures, pollen grains and the ovules only, reproduction will forwarded, okay, to give birth to next generation. Okay, this is about reproduction and parts involved in a flower. Calyx is a green colored part present above the stalk. Corolla, white colored portion present in Dhatura plant only it is in white color, but in hibiscus it is in red color. So flower to flower color is different. Okay, male portion is called as andrecium, female portion is called as gynoecium. Andrecium includes stamen and anther. Anther is also called as pollen sac. Inside the pollen sac, a powder like grains like structures present, those are called as pollen grains. Okay, gynoecium is female reproductive part. Female reproductive part having ovary. Here it is ovary. This is ovary. Above it is style. Above to this a bead like structure called as stigma. These overall three structures are combinedly called as gynoecium. Inside the ovary, what are the structures present? Those are ovules. Those are called as ovules. Ovules nothing but egg shaped structures. Okay, then unisexual flowers. No. Before that, I want to discuss about complete flowers and incomplete flowers. Complete flowers and incomplete flowers. Complete flower means a flower having four borers. I said that four borers are calyx, corolla, andrecium and gynoecium. If the flower having completely four borers, the type of flowers are called as, okay, complete flowers. That means four borers. Okay, these are called as complete flowers. What are the four borers? Calyx, corolla, andrecium and gynecium. What are the examples for the complete flower are sunflower, okay, datura, hibiscus, ipomia, then brinjal flowers, etc. Okay, these are complete flowers because four whorls are present, that's why these are called as complete flowers. But here one important thing is present, that is about sunflower. If you see a sunflower, okay, this is not the complete sunflower, you just assume that, okay, this is maybe a sunflower. Okay, wait, I will draw. Okay, now it is seems like a sunflower. Then inside a sunflower there are small hair like structures are present. If you observe it, it has small hair like fine structures are called as florets. Why it is called as floret? Sunflower is not a flower. Sunflower, it is doesn't call it as flower because it is called as floret. Why it is called as floret? Floret is a bunch of flowers is called as floret. Here I mentioned small hair like fine structures are present inside at the center of the sunflower. These are called as flowers. Okay, floret is a bunch of flowers. Those flowers are present at the center region. Some flowers are present. Those are called as disc flowers. At the edges, some flowers are present. Those are called as ray flowers. These ray flowers are male portions. Ray flowers are male portions. These disc flowers includes female portion. Okay, so complete flower having both male and female portions along with the calyx and the corolla. These are the corolla part. Here it is a calyx part is present. Andricium is ray flowers. Gynecium is disc flower. But sunflower belongs to floret. Floret means bunch of flowers. Those bunch of flowers present at center region. At the center region, disc flowers are present. At the center region, disc flowers are present. At the ends of the floret, ray flowers are present. These are the ray flowers are present. This is about sunflower. Then, complete flower is over. Next thing, incomplete flower. Incomplete flower. Incomplete flowers means, okay, among the four whorls, is there any one is missed here, that is called as incomplete. That means any one of the whorl missed, it is called as incomplete flower. That means if calyx is missed, it is It is under the category incomplete flower. If the corolla is missed, it is called as incomplete flower. If only having antherium but does not having gynoecium, it is called as incomplete flower. Okay. So, incomplete flower means, examples for the incomplete flower are cucumber, watermelon. Okay. Then, jackfruit plant. Then, okay, these are the examples for bitter gourd or bottle gourd. These are the example for incomplete flower. In these flowers only present either antherium or gynoecium. Either of one of the antherium or gynoecium only present, both are not present. That's why it is under the incomplete flower. So tell me, from this we can say what is unisexual flower, what is bisexual flower. Unisexual flower having either of the sex means, that is, maybe having male or female. Okay, maybe having male or female. If male is present, female is absent. If female flowers are present, that means female portion. Gynoecium is present, male portion, that is antherium is absent. Those types of flowers are called as unisexual flowers. But in some flowers, both antherium and gynoecium are present. Both antherium and gynoecium are present. That's why it is called as bisexual. Bi means two. Both the sexual parts, male and female portions, are present in a single flower. That's why this type of flowers are called as bisexual flowers. Unisexual flowers, examples, same as it is cucumber. That means incomplete flower, unisexual flower have similarities. Why? Because unisexual flower having either of the sexes, that means here either of the one whorl is missed, that's why it is incomplete flower. Bisexual flower having two whorls like antherium and gynoecium along with the calyx and corolla, that it is included under complete flower. The examples for bisexual flower is Datura, Hibiscus, Ipomoea. Incomplete flower and unisexual flowers are same. Okay, now diagrammatically I represented here what is unisexual flower and what is bisexual flower. This is a flower. Okay, if you observe that here only ovary, style, stigma is present. Okay, in some flowers like. These are stamens. That means a flower having only stamens, it is called as unisexual. If the flower having only gynoecium, it is called as unisexual flower. That means unisexual flower having either gynoecium or stamens, these are called as unisexual flowers. If bisexual flower is Datura or Hibiscus. Okay, take an example, Hibiscus. This is Hibiscus. From this Hibiscus, this is stigma. Here ovary is present. Here ovary is present. Here stamens. These are called as stamens. These are called as stamens. That means both female and that means stigma is present, style is present, stigma, style, ovary is present. Then stamens also present, stamens also present. These are male portions, these are female portions. So both types of female and male are present here in case of hibiscus. So these are called as bisexual, bisexual flowers, bisexual flowers. Okay, this is about unisexual and bisexual flowers. Another thing, take an example of papaya plant. Take an example of papaya plant. Papaya plant, it is having both male flowers and female flowers in the same plant or different plants. Okay, take an example, papaya plant. If you observe that both male flowers are there, female flowers also there, but they are present in separate flowers. Both male and female sections present in separate flowers. Okay, but in case of cucumber, but in case of cucumber, okay, male flowers present in one plant, male flowers are present in one plant, female flowers are present in another plant, second plant. Okay, even though both male and female flowers present in a same plant, but they are separately found. So papaya plant is not included under bisexual. Bisexual plant having only both male and female portions in a same flower, but not on a same plant. It having both male flowers separately and female flowers separately. So it is also called as unisexual plant, unisexual plant. Okay, this is about unisexual and bisexual and complete and incomplete. Then sexual parts of the flower. I said that what are the sexes present in a flower? Male portion is called as andrecium. Male portion is called as andrecium. Female portion is called as gynoecium. Am I correct? Andrecium includes stamen and anther. Stamen and anther. Gynoecium having ovary, style and stigma. These are the sexual parts of the flower. Okay, sexual parts of the flower, and these are also called as essential parts of the flower. Essential parts of the flower. Okay, thank you.